Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. Today we are going to analyze the Hindu newspaper for 6th of July 2020. आप सभी का स्वागत है अर्पिता शर्मा क्लासेस में. आज हम 6th जुलाई 2020 का द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर एनालाइज करने जा रहे हैं. सो बिफोर एनालाइजिंग द न्यूज़पेपर, देयर इज अ स्मॉल अनाउंसमेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. द क्लास पीडीएफ्स आर अवेलेबल ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल. क्लास के पीडीएफ जो होते हैं, रिसोर्सेज, नोट्स एटसेट्रा, एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल. And it is timely uploaded there as well. चाहे वो हिंदू की क्लास हो या किसी और टॉपिक की क्लास हो, सारे नोट्स, सारे रिसोर्सेज आपको टेलीग्राम चैनल पे मिल जाएंगे. And we do not analyze the newspapers on Sundays. That is for your own self study. Sundays को newspaper analysis नहीं होता है. It's only from Monday to Saturday. Okay? Monday to Saturday आपको सारी videos, classes मिलेंगी. But Sundays को newspaper का analysis आपको खुद से करना है. All right? Also, here's a small announcement for all of you. आप सभी के लिए एक छोटी सी अनाउंसमेंट है. आई एम टेकिंग कोर्सेज ऑन अनअकैडमी प्लस. अनअकैडमी प्लस पर भी मैं कोर्सेज ले रही हूँ. इफ यू विश टू सब्सक्राइब टू अनअकैडमी प्लस, यू कैन गेट 10% डिस्काउंट बाई यूजिंग दिस रेफरल कोड Sharma20. ये रेफरल कोड यूज करके आपको इजिली 10% डिस्काउंट अनअकैडमी प्लस के सब्सक्रिप्शन पर मिल सकता है. एंड क्लास नोट्स ऑन टेलीग्राम चैनल सिंप्लीफाइंग यूपीएससी विद ईज. Now let's start with the classes. Now the first case that we are going to discuss today is, पहला जो हम केस डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं वो है इटालियन मरीन्स केस, एनरिका लेक्सी केस, दैट इज इटली वर्सेज इंडिया. इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ GS पेपर 2, इंडिया इटली रिलेशंस, इंटरनेशनल लॉज एंड पॉलिसीज. लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड वॉट दिस केस इज ऑल अबाउट. इट्स एन ऑनगोइंग इंटरनेशनल कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी अबाउट अ शूटिंग दैट हैपेंड ऑफ the western coast of India. So it's a case of a controversial shooting that happened at the western coast of India, and this happened on 15th Feb 2012. Two Indian fishermen on board, so there were two Indian fishermen on board Indian fishing vessel, they were killed off the coast of Kerala. And after they were fired upon by Italian marines on board the Italian flagged commercial oil tanker MV Enrica Lexi. This was the oil tanker through which the Italian marines, they shot the Indian fishermen and they were killed on spot. Italy had approached the International Tribunal for Law of the Sea, which is also known as ITLOS. So Italy approached ITLOS in 2015 and the matter was heard by Permanent Court of Arbitration in July 2019. 2015 mein is case ko Italy ITLOS ke paas lekar gayi, right? एंड 2019 में जाकर इसकी हियरिंग हुई. इन न्यूज, व्हाट इज इन न्यूज राइट नाउ? नाउ परमानेंट कोर्ट ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन, दिस कोर्ट, दिस ट्राइब्यूनल हैज नाउ रूल्ड दैट इटालियन मरीन्स हेल्ड डिप्लोमेटिक इम्यूनिटी प्रोटेक्शन. इम्यूनिटी मीन्स प्रोटेक्शन, एंड वुड फेस अ ट्रायल इन इटली एंड नॉट इन इंडिया. पीसीए ने कहा है कि इंडिया में, बिकॉज इंडियन फिशरमैन वर किल्ड, सो इंडिया वॉज सेइंग दैट ट्रायल्स विल बी हेल्ड इन इंडिया. But PCA said because it is a case of diplomatic immunity, that is why the trials will be conducted in Italy and not in India. However, Permanent Court of Arbitration Tribunal found merit in India's counterclaim that the marines on board Enrica Lexi had violated freedom of navigation rights under the United Nations Convention on Law of the Sea by shooting at fishing boat and should pay compensation to the victims' families. So PCA finally has agreed to India's plea that the marines should pay compensation to the victims' families because they have violated the rights of these Indian fishermen. The tribunal said that India must cease to exercise its jurisdiction and the hearing will be done in Italy. This is the news. Theek hai, itna samajh aaya? Now what are the key takeaways from this judgment? The Permanent Court of Arbitration, which is in The Hague, it has admitted that both India and Italy had concurrent jurisdiction in the matter, but concluded that Marine's immunity precluded India's jurisdiction. India and Italy both have jurisdiction in this case, but because of the Marine's immunity protection which has been given to Marines, this case will be heard in Italy. So it will not be heard in India. Diplomatic immunity, now what is it? अब ये डिप्लोमेटिक इम्यूनिटी होता क्या है, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट. डिप्लोमेटिक इम्यूनिटी अंडर द वियना कन्वेंशन ऑन डिप्लोमेटिक रिलेशंस, इट स्पेसिफाइज द प्रिविलेजेस ऑफ अ डिप्लोमेटिक मिशन that enable the diplomats to perform their diplomatic functions without fear of any legal trouble or harassment from the host country. Here in this case, host country was India. इस केस में होस्ट कंट्री कौन थी? इंडिया थी, ठीक है? In India's favor, the PC has found that Italian vessel had violated the right and freedom of navigation of Indian fishing vessel under UN clause. So that is why the family, the Italian marines will compensate the family of the Indian fishermen. They have merited the compensation. Clear? It asked the parties to consult each other on the compensation which is due to India as a result. Now what are the concerns in this case? Is case mein ab concerns kya nikal kar aayenge samne? The PCA's award, which is final, that is the verdict of this tribunal is final and it has been accepted by India also. But it is a huge setback for the expectation that the two Marines would face a criminal trial in India. Since 2015, we were expecting that the criminal proceedings will be held in India only. But because of this tribunal's verdict, now it is a huge setback to our expectations. The Union government should have taken over the prosecution and ensured a quick trial. Since 2015, this case has been pending. And right now, after 5 years, this tribunal has said that the hearing will be heard in Italy. The criminal proceedings will be done in Italy. So why it took 5 long years to come up to this conclusion, right? Clear? Now here for prelims, what is important? These topics are important for prelims. Please make sure that you note them down. First, permanent court of arbitration. What is it? Ab ye permanent court of arbitration kya hai? It is established pursuant to the Hague Peace Convention of 1899. It is in the Hague in Netherlands. It provides wide range of dispute resolution services. It is different from ITLOS. There is close working relationship between ITLOS and PCA in solving the maritime disputes. Now what is ITLOS? It is International Tribunal for Law of the Sea, intergovernmental organization created by mandate of 3rd United Nations Conference on Law of the Sea. It was established by United Nations Convention on Law of the Sea, which was signed in Jamaica in 1982. The convention entered into force in 1994. You have to remember when it was signed and when it came into force. Okay, 1982 mein isko sign kiya gaya tha, 1994 mein ये अस्तित्व में आया. एंड इट एस्टैब्लिश्ड एन इंटरनेशनल फ्रेमवर्क फॉर लॉ ओवर ऑल ओशन स्पेस इट्स यूजेस एंड रिसोर्सेस. क्लियर? नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ यूएन क्लॉज? फ्रीडम ऑफ हाई सीज, पीसफुल यूज ऑफ वर्ल्ड ओशंस, नेशनल सोवरेन ओवर टेरिटोरियल वाटर्स, फ्रीडम ऑफ इनोसेंट पैसेज ऑफ द शिप्स थ्रू टेरिटोरियल वाटर्स एंड आर्किपेलागिक जोन्स, peaceful settlement of dispute, marine environment protection, freedom of transportation, transit through international straits. And these are the features of UN clause, that every state shall effectively exercise its jurisdiction in the matters of ships flying its flag, piracy as per UN clause, any illegal act of violence or detention, act of depredation committed for private ends by the crew or the passengers of a private ship or a private aircraft will be punished. High seas represent that sea area which is not a part of any sovereign state. This is very important for prelims. Isko yaad rakhna. Ye high seas kya hota hai? It is that part of the sea which does not come under any sovereign state. The high seas are open to all states. Koi ek territorial jurisdiction koi country exercise nahi kar sakti. Okay? Right of innocent passage, seizure of pirate ship, right of hot pursuit. Hot pursuit of foreign ship may be undertaken when competent authorities of coastal state have a good reason to believe that the ship has violated the laws and regulations of that state. Okay? Now the next important news, China doubles down on claims on eastern Bhutan boundary. China has doubled down, including Bhutan's eastern sectors, to the boundary dispute between the two countries for the first time. Days after Bhutan sent China a demand protesting against Chinese claims to the Sakteng Wildlife Sanctuary in eastern Bhutan, Beijing has doubled down, including Bhutan's eastern sectors, to boundary dispute between two countries for the first time. Finally, China, what it is doing? It is doubling its claim over some areas in Bhutan. Right? China kar kya raha hai? कि जो बाउंड्री लाइन है ना चाइना और भूटान के बीच में, उसको कभी डिलिमिट नहीं किया गया. तो चाइना अपने क्लेम्स को बढ़ा रहा है कि भाई ये एरिया भी हमारे क्षेत्र में आएगा, ये एरिया भी हमारे क्षेत्र में आएगा. सो इट इज डबलिंग डाउन द एरियाज एंड इट इज क्लेमिंग दैट दीज एरियाज इन ईस्टर्न भूटान विल कम अंडर आर टेरिटरी. right? This is the issue which is going on. As per records, there has been no mention of Eastern Bhutan or Trashgang Dzongkhag district, where Saktang Wildlife Sanctuary is based, which borders Arunachal Pradesh in 24 previous rounds of boundary negotiations. Negotiations have not been held since Doklam standoff between Indian and Chinese troops in 2017. That was also between the issue between China and Bhutan, but India interfered in that issue, right? And India supported Bhutan in that issue. So a brief overview of boundary dispute between China and Bhutan. Bhutan and China have no formal diplomatic relations. Remember this. The talks concentrated on North and West Bhutan regions, which were held between 1984 and 2016. Boundary related issues se related baatein hui thi Bhutan aur China ke beech mein 1984 se 2016 tak. Then 2017 ke baad koi meeting nahi hui. And right now the controversial point over here is this Saktang Wildlife Sanctuary. China is claiming that it is under their jurisdiction. Bhutan is saying it is a part of Eastern Bhutan. It is our part. Eastern Bhutan not part of the talk so far, but right now Saktang Sanctuary is situated close to the border with Arunachal Pradesh. If China claims its territorial jurisdiction over this wildlife sanctuary, then India and China, the relation between both the nations will also come into strain because Arunachal Pradesh is close to this wildlife reserve, right? And already China is trying to control Arunachal Pradesh, okay? Next important news, vaccine trials take 6 to 9 months, said WHO chief scientist. Days after Indian Council of Medical Research issued a letter calling for fast-tracking the trial process of Bharat Biotech's COVID-19 vaccine, that is Covaxin, chief scientist at World Health Organization Soumya Swaminathan said, vaccine trial usually takes at least 6 months to complete. This is important for prelims. Ye aapke prelims ke liye kaafi important hai. Vaccine trials kam se kam 6 se 9 month mahine lagte hain isko complete hone mein. A realistic timeline from the start of phase 1 to the completion of phase 3 trials could be about to 6 to 9 months if everything goes according to the plan. So let us understand the history of vaccines in our country, which is important for GS paper 3 and your prelims. Did you know that the first vaccine, pehli vaccine jo develop hui thi, it was by Edward Jenner in 1790s against smallpox. The points I am highlighting are important for prelims. Jo points main highlight kar rahi hu wo prelims ke liye important hai. Now for smallpox, complete eradication was declared by WHO or WHA in 1979. Eradication means, it means permanent reduction to zero new cases worldwide. Right. Fast forward to 21st century, the spread of COVID-19 has necessitated the development of a new vaccine. This is the biggest challenge, that we have to develop a new vaccine in minimum time possible because the pandemic is very, very scary right now. So in 1974, this is the timeline, historical timeline. 1974, WHO launches EPI. The goal of this vaccine was every child who is, less than 1 year of age receives protection against childhood disease, tuberculosis, polio, diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, measles. Then tetanus toxoid vaccinations protect women and their newborns. 1974, this was launched. In 1990, vaccination protects more than 80% of world's children from 6 main EPI diseases. These were EPI diseases, right? Then in 1999, Global Alliance for Vaccine and Immunization, which is known as GAVI, it was launched, which extended its reach to EPI disease. It helped protect the poorest countries in identifying the new vaccines, developing the new vaccines. Majority of scientists are of the view that it will take around 12 to 18 months for a COVID-19 vaccine to develop. And WHO Secretary Soumya Swaminathan is saying that it will take 6 to 9 months to complete the trial, the testing of Covaxin. Okay. Now, why it will take such a huge amount of time? There are two reasons. Huge body of research had already been done on coronaviruses. China provided genome sequence of the new coronavirus, which confirmed that COVID-19 virus has 79% of its genetic material same as SARS. That is why it will take 12 to 18 months to finally develop a vaccine. Now let us tell you how a vaccine works. A vaccine operates by introducing the weakened or inactive antigens of pathogen in your immune system. Then your immune system, when it will come in contact with this inactive antigen, it will produce antibodies in response to the identification of foreign body in one system. As a result, when the same pathogen attacks the body in future, it immediately produces antibodies based on registered memory. होता क्या है वैक्सीन में ना, जैसे मान लो आपको पोलियो के लिए वैक्सीन दी जा रही है, तो वही पोलियो में जो एंटीजेंस होंगे वो आपकी बॉडी में डाले जाएंगे. बेसिकली आपको इन्फेक्ट किया जाएगा इसी डिजीज के एंटीजेंस से. आपकी इम्यून सिस्टम क्या करेगी, एंटीबॉडीज को प्रिपेयर करेगी, क्योंकि एक फॉरेन बॉडी आपके फॉरेन यू नो बॉडी आपके सिस्टम में एंटर किया है फॉरेन बॉडी ने, तो एंटीबॉडीज प्रोड्यूस किए जाएंगे आपकी इम्यून सिस्टम के द्वारा इस फॉरेन बॉडी से लड़ने के लिए, ताकि फ्यूचर में कभी पोलियो आपकी बॉडी को इन्फेक्ट करता है तो ये एंटीबॉडीज पहले से प्रिपेयर होंगे उससे फाइट करने के लिए. सिमिलरली आपकी बॉडी में अभी COVID-19 के एंटीजेंस डाले जाएंगे अगर वैक्सीन तैयार होती है, ताकि आपकी बॉडी के इम्यून सिस्टम का एंटीबॉडी जो होगा उसके मेमोरी में होगा कि हमने पहले भी इस तरीके के फॉरेन बॉडी को मारा है, तो वापस से आपकी इम्यून सिस्टम इस फॉरेन बॉडी से लड़ेगी और आपको प्रोटेक्ट करेगी. राइट, नाउ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट फेजेस इन वैक्सीन डेवलपमेंट. बेसिकली देयर आर फोर फेजेस, चार फेज होते हैं वैक्सीन डेवलपमेंट के. फर्स्ट फेज इज रिसर्च. विदाउट रिसर्च यू कैन नॉट डेवलप एनीथिंग न्यू, यू कैन नॉट इनोवेट. So research is the first phase in which identification of biological pathogen is done through genetic sequencing. Second phase is known as trial vaccine, which is trials are conducted on animals, जैसे कि mice or goats, right? Trials किए जाते हैं animals के ऊपर vaccines को, उसके बाद उनको humans पे try किया जाता है, right? So you can see first phase is known as the research phase. Second phase is clinical trials which are done on animals. Then third phase is regulatory process and fourth phase is manufacturing and distribution. So third is once the vaccine is finalized to be distributed amongst people, it has to undergo approval by government regulatory authorities, for example Food and Drug Administration in US. And then once the approval has been given, it is manufactured and distributed. Okay, clear? Next important news, the secret of how caterpillars tame ants. This is only important for prelims. Ye sirf prelims ke liye important hai. Scientists from National Center of Biological Science in Bengaluru have got fascinating insights into the relations of caterpillars and their ant host using advanced X-ray micro CT technology. So here you just have to study the advanced X-ray micro CT technology. Aapko sirf ye padhna hai. What is the usage of this technology? What are the applications of this technology? Okay? Then you have to study butterflies of the family Lycaenidae known as blues and hair streaks. So blues and hair streaks you have to remember for prelims. Aapko isko prelims ke liye yaad rakhna hai. Clear? Now let's solve some questions for prelims. Mock questions. Question number one. Consider the following statements regarding decarbonizing transport in emerging economies project. Niti Aayog has been instrumental in the launch of decarbonizing transport in emerging economies project in India. Project will help India develop a pathway towards low carbon transport system. Out of total carbon dioxide emissions in India, more than 50% come from the transport sector. Which statement is correct? Kaun sa statement correct hai? You have 5 seconds time to answer the question. 5 seconds ka time hai question answer karne ka aap logo ke paas. Correct answer to this question is A. That is statement 1 and statement 2 are correct. Statement number 3 is wrong. It says out of the total carbon dioxide emissions, more than 50% come from transport sector. That is wrong. It is 13%. Okay? Question number 2. Consider the following statements. The government recently approved the creation of In Space, a space organization to ensure greater private participation in India's space activities. New Space India Limited is only public sector company that serve as a marketing arm of ISRO. Which statement is incorrect? False statement kaun si identify karni hai aapko? Correct answer to this question is B. That is statement 2 is incorrect. Statement 2 incorrect hai, statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is an extreme statement. Only bol raha hai ye. Extreme statements are 99% of the time incorrect. Okay? It is a public sector company, right? But it is not the only public sector company. Remember this. Question number 3. Nikshay Poshan Yojana, sometimes seen in news, is related to reduce child mortality due to pneumonia, provision of free dialysis services to the poor, नेशनल टीबी एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम, नेशनल एड्स कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम. वेरी केयरफुली रीड द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चन. बहुत ही केयरफुली क्वेश्चन को पढ़ के आंसर करना है. करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज इट इज सी, नेशनल टीबी एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम. इट इज अ वेब इनेबल्ड पेशेंट मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम फॉर टीबी कंट्रोल एंड इट इज डेवलप्ड अंडर NTEP, दैट इज नेशनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम. It is developed and maintained by Central TB Division, which is under Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, in collaboration with National Informatics Center and WHO. Okay. Next question, question number 4. Consider the following statements regarding conservation reserves and community reserves. Conservation reserves and community reserves in India are terms denoting protected areas of India, which typically act as buffer zones between national parks. These categories were first introduced in the Environment Protection Act 1986, and Lakshadweep Islands recently announced the creation of world's first conservation area for sea cucumbers. Which statement is correct? Kaun sa statement correct hai? Correct answer to this question is it is C. That is statement 1 and statement 3 are correct. Statement 2 is wrong. Okay. So, this particular conservation reserves, they are protected under category. They are protected areas categorized by Union Environment Ministry under WPA 2002. Okay. So, this statement is wrong. Last question for today. Lampedusa Island, sometimes seen in news, is located in Mediterranean Sea, Red Sea, Black Sea, or Adriatic Sea. Correct answer to this question is it is Mediterranean Sea. Over here you can see. Aap idhar dekh sakte ho. Lampedusa is the largest island of Italian Pelagic Islands in the Mediterranean Sea. These are the Pelagic Island, jiska part hai Lampedusa Island. It is in the Mediterranean Sea. Clear? So this was all for today. I hope you enjoyed today's class. If you really enjoyed it, do not forget to share the video with other aspirants, subscribe to the channel, and also press the bell icon to never miss an update. Thank you.